Hello, everyone who are part of Akiba's trip. This time we're going to be going to our main mission because we have no submissions. I don't want to fucking do anything else right now. I just want to go to the main mission and get this over with. Because I feel like things are going to get worse for me. Because they always do.
Hey, you're back. Took you long enough. Where were you two? We were getting worried.
I'm sorry. It's just that...
Wow, that's heavy stuff. So you're not human then, Shizuku?
By appearances, you look like an ordinary cute girl.
So that's how you were able to distinguish synthesters from normal humans then?
Well, I can tell synthesters from normal humans, too, when I'm fighting them.
I'm so sorry to have kept the truth from you all this time. You may pass judgment on me as you see fit. But for now, I'd ask that you please let me rest for a while.
Hmm? Oh, sure. The upstairs room is all yours. Guess an awful lot's happened lately. You gotta be tired.
If you'll excuse me, then.
So, what are you gonna do? You gonna tell her it's okay, or not?
Whatever all she did, Shizuku saved my life.
Well, I suppose that is true.
Come on now, this is serious stuff.
Oh, it's the sister.
Prototype, is it true? Are you not human? Have you been made into an inhuman monster?
No, it's not like he was really doing anything with his humanity before, you know?
He is, as you said, not human. Or inhuman. Possibly superhuman. It's a bit unclear.
Well, all right. I'm okay with this. He is who he is. I'm going to bed.
More things change, the more they stay the same. We may know what Shizuku's deal is now, but what we gotta do ain't changed one bit. Crazy things are still going down in Akiba, and it's all on us to take care of them.
You got that right.
But we still don't have a firm grasp on what this organization even is, nor do we have any real plan for quelling the attacks.
Hey, hey, hey! You all need to light up before you walk out that door. Akiba freedom fighters have no room for the dark side. Maybe as we go, we can even find a way to change you back.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. We need to keep our heads up higher than ever in times like this.
Hey, why not? A forced smile's still a smile.
All right. So let's all paste on some smiles and head out on patrol like usual.
It's got some beatballs over at it.
Your sense of timing for inappropriate interjections is kind of amazing. You know that? Anyway, let's go to Akihabara Park.
Oh, now I can go to the fucking park. Okay. Good. Good. Another fucking side mission from Spikey. What? Oh, you were just joking. Oh, you're so funny. Wait, she gave me two messages. What's this one? Yeah. Even though I'm not human, you're still a pain in the ass. That'll never change, ever. Hey, look, cosplay. Oh, cosplay fest, any minute now. Oh, I give a whole lot of a shit about this. Goodbye. And hey, side missions. We have three of them. We have the Akiba Navigator, PlayStation. Okay. And Skullgirl. Now, all two difficulties. That's an easy one. I think we can handle this. Oh, and one of my clients is called Wang. Because of course it's gonna be called Wang. Because it's this game, why would there not be a character called Wang? Like... Anyway, Caddy has a fucking mission for me. Like, I don't know if it's abusing or not, but... gee, why? I thought the clients are for random people, not for fucking Mograd. Just... whatever. Yep. The Dengeki PlayStation is... oh my god, of course it does. You wanna purchase it, you're very, very busy. Yeah, sure. I'm surprised you even give somewhat of a shit about the PlayStation magazines, which are currently pretty shit nowadays. Anyway, here's Nanashi, here's your brother. Oh, I can't do it. Thank fuck. Okay, let's think about this. Let's go with, let's go with the easy one. Let's go get the magazine. I'm pretty sure it'll cost me some cash, but really, it's not that bad. I don't think it will hurt me that much if I do this. Okay, let's see. I also have Toko. I just noticed that. So, Toko's been pretty decent. I'm pretty sure that'll be a good idea for me to have her now. Especially since Shizuku is resting right now. But for now, to the magazine, which is right over here. Oh. He purchased... oh, wow. We have a hoarder. Okay. That's got a radio Kaiken area. Okay. Which is where another side mission is, yeah. I think this one's the schoolgirl one. We can do this. We can handle this. Just have to go and find the shop. It's right over here at the very end. Oh, what? Really? Are you fucking kidding me? Okay. Well, got another side mission over here. Oh, it's at Main Street now. I got another side mission though. So I'll deal with this later on. And right now, let's go ahead and deal with the schoolgirl. It has to be something like okay with this one. Yeah. Okay. That is pretty annoying. Alright, I will. Sure. What? 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 Shut up, Toko. Now's the time to talk about the fucking arena. What the fuck? What was the description? This name is given. Oh no! Oh no! This side mission is gonna make me a cross-dresser? No! No! Oh no! Oh no! Fuck! Please don't tell. No, it does! Oh, I have to let the gayest motherfucker to- oh, no! Oh, fuck you, game! And fuck you, Spikestuff! Oh, what? Oh, hey, Wang! How's it going, Wang? Oh, you wanna go to that area? Okay. Oh my god. They're blushing at me because I'm fucking cross-dressing. Why? Okay. Anyway, this one's kind of weird, this side mission. You have to go inside the shop, then leave. And because of this, he'll go inside the shop, and that's how you get through this side mission. You can't just walk it through the infant. You can't just walk past it. You have to go inside and then come out, and Wang will just go inside himself and then come out real quickly, and that's it. So, yeah, that's the side mission. It sucks. So I'll just cut to when I get to the shops and just go inside and then get out. Nice outfit, dude. Right, Wang's got a bunch of games, he bought all of them, and he did buy all of them. Now I have to go to the main street southeast. Okay. Let's go ahead over. I'm gonna jump cut value from waiting for the loading screen. So Lemtara. Wait, it's the same fucking guy! What are you cloning? Maybe some of these guys are fucking simpsters. We don't know it. We got a soft map. Well, we already know what a soft map is, so it's just right ahead of us. Jump cutting, though. Because I don't want to waste any more of my time. Oh, by the way, anime. Right, he's inside the shop now. Just gonna wait a bit. Oh my god. Can't believe I'm fucking cross-dresser now. That's great. Of all the things. Wait. Want me to go to... There's no shops in UD+. Where the fuck do I go for this part? There's no shops here in UD+. What the fuck? What? Oh. Okay. Oh. Hi there. Really? Sure. He's not really that bad of a problem. Oh, you got more people. There's a lot of people. Okay, so, this part's gonna be a big part. You see, there are two really big fights in this part, and this is the first one. Now, for both of these, I'm not gonna edit any of the fighting. You will see all of it, and I mean all of it, because you know how the side mission was a 2-star? I consider this a 4-star. Why? Because fighting every single one of these motherfuckers and defeating this area is a pain in the ass. They all have some strong fucking weapons. One of them appears to have a crowbar. And, like, they have bus signs and those radio tower things. And some of them use, like, swords and bats. And some of them just have their fists. Because they want to fucking box me in the face, I guess. And right now, all Toko's dealing with is one guy while I'm dealing with a fucking horde. So... yeah, kind of in a bad position. And the worst part, the absolute worst part, is when you go this direction. Because you're so busy fighting these guys, you want to take these fuckers down. If you go in this direction, the camera locks in a specific direction. And the absolute worst part is if you get stuck where the Mogra exit is, you can't fucking see yourself. I thought I was going to be fucked over because of that. But somehow, I made it through and I survived. I don't know how. By the way, Toko has lost her pants. So, that's one guy and she is having a hard time dealing with him. While I'm fucking fighting a horde of them, and she's saying she's wearing a bind here. Yeah, you have no fucking problem, sir. You're like fucking fighting one guy, and I'm fighting the rest of them. Thanks, Toko. You fucking bitch. This will be the last time, too. The second big fight is the same thing. Like, the horde coming for me. But the good news is, a lot more than one is fighting Toko. And I have a third person with me fighting, so... you know. That's good news. But yeah, I honestly don't like this one. Especially when you consider the fact that this fucking camera angle exists. Look at this. There are so many fucking blind spots when you're in that angle. It sucks. So I'm trying my hardest not to get anywhere near that fucking camera angle. I do not want to get screwed over. And now it's time for a big strip-a-thon. Oh great, I couldn't even see that one. That's good. Thanks, game. So good. Yeah, I'm kicking everyone's ass right now. I'm doing pretty good. Just beating the fucking shit out of them. And that's it. And nailed it. And now they're naked. Of course they are. Now I have the ability to fuck someone up, and that guy still has all his clothes, so I'm gonna take him down with this power. This is Toko's, by the way. Boom! Kicking him in the ass. And get ready for this. Boom! He's not down, but he's stunned everybody, and his pants are all that's left, so that's good news. But yeah. So far, there's not many people who still have all their clothes on. It's like two guys. I can handle this. So, if it wasn't for the fact my fighting in this game is really fucking dumb, I would be able to get through this relatively well. Except that the camera angle was being a prick, which, by the way, it's gonna be a prick. It's gonna get in the way. And it's gonna suck. See, fuck this move. Why the fuck does this move exist? Why can't I just punch him down like normal, like this? I just wanna punch him in the pants. And the game will let me have the satisfaction of punching them in the pants. What the fuck? And sometimes, I jump instead of fucking punching them in the pants. It's stupid. And now I'm getting stuck over here. I'm trying to run away. I'm trying to get healed. And now I'm stuck. I can't get the fuck out because they're following me. And I can't see. I'm seriously fucked. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know where the fuck I am. And now I'm where the fucking... I'm at the mocha area now. And look, I can't see where I am. Can you see where I am? I can't. I'm currently fucked. I got lucky somehow. I got out of that. I don't know how. I should have been fucked over completely there. I should have lost. But now I'm ripping people's clothes off and get ready. The camera's gonna switch right now. Yeah. Now you get to see all the jump gun that's weirdly put in. Right. I got 500 at least. But we only got like 3 people left, and the first guy over there that Toko's dealing with, he has headphones on, of course he does. Oh, and they stop fighting when I'm ripping someone's clothes off, by the way, that's a thing. The worst part is this guy has all his clothes on, I think. Yeah, he has all his clothes on, because I'm punching him in the chest and actually there's dealing damage, so, great. This fucker is the only person who has all his clothes on. I hate when that fucking happens. Why the fuck is Toko so worthless? Why is she fighting the parts that they fucking ripped off? Like, seriously! Fight him in the head! Oh, now your pants are gone! Good job, Toko! Fuck me! And that's all I could took off. And now I'm fucking kicking your ass. 1, 2, 3, 4, fuck you! And now for Stunlock. Also, give me some time to take down this motherfucker. Watch. Oh! Thank you! Thank you, Toko! It took you the last guy to fucking do the right thing. Anyway. Nothing else around here. As there is, I can't fucking see it. So we're done with the fight. Now we have to go back and talk to the guy to get our reward. Hey, Wang. Did you have fun shopping? Okay. Yeah, no problem. Good. Sure. Thanks. It better be good. I better get 10,000 yen for this. Sure. Whatever. I'm gonna fucking kill you! Fucking. Okay. Okay. Whatever. I got another hell to deal with. I got Spikey to fucking deal with. So what is it, sister?
Mission.
Fuck you! Fuck you! And fuck you, Spikestuff! Fucking stalker shit now? Okay. So he makes fan art, and now he doesn't want to do it anymore. That's fine. Like, why? If he doesn't want to fucking do it, then why force him? Whatever, just give me a fucking clue. Okay. Okay, thank you. You're actually telling me where to go. Thank you for giving me some kind of hint. Instead of making me go on a fucking witch hunt for this guy. Right. So here's the first shop employee. Alright. So they're bestsellers. How the fuck is... this is a fan comic. How is this a bestseller? We got the other shop over here, which should have the magazine. Of course you sold out! What? Wait, what? Oh, come back here! Oh, you fucking son of a bitch. Okay. We're going on a fucking chase then. Where is he? Side streets? Yeah, I'm sure we can secure a copy of a fucking hoarder. Like, that's gonna really work. But there are people in real life who do this shit. They fucking buy shit that people ought to want, and they don't fucking give it away. Oh, he's a trapeze maniac. That's good. Yeah, he's not giving it away. Yeah, even if 5 times of retail price, he ain't giving me it. Like, I might as well just say, fuck it. Retail price, please. Yeah, I have no choice. I have to beat the shit out of this guy. Here, I'm gonna punch the shit out of you. Yeah, he's a hoarder. And now to fucking murder a hoarder. How appropriate. There are some dickheads out there on the internet you'll find that will just not ever give people an ISO or anything of a game. But they're complete assholes. And this is what I want to do with them. Did it. Oh, you want to fight? No! I'm not fucking fighting you guys! I did my thing, I got my magazine. Fuck you, I'm leaving. Hey, Caddy, here's your magazine. It better be better than that motherfucking Wang bullshit, man. It better be better than that. It is. Thank you. 10,000 yen, I am happy with that. No problem. Okay, 2 other areas. One of them's gonna be fucking Spikey's bullshit. The other one's gonna be the female crap. Okay. The guy I'm supposed to stalk should be around here.
Welcome back.
Hey, maid. Yeah, I'm looking for that guy. He's not here. Fucking hell. Okay, he goes to the park. Wait. Oh no. I can't do it because of main missions. Oh no, that means I only have the fucking... Okay. Hang on. First, I need something before I do this. So I'm going to the shop. And I'm going to buy this. A girl strategic t-shirt. I need this. Because I don't have any female shirts. Okay. I hate doing this. I do not want to do this, but... let's put on our fucking female shirt. Yep, this one. It's close to our decent one, at least. Let's put on our fucking shitty ladies' denim pants. And our brown long boots. And now, I can go and attract all the males and turn them completely gay. Because that's a thing now. That's a fucking thing now. Well, let's go find these guys and attract them to my womanly charms. Oh my fucking god, these guys are dumb. You know what? I'm gonna hang them off a bridge by their balls. I think that's an appropriate thing that feminists say or something like that. I don't fucking know. Okay, now I'm fine with really shitty clothes. That's not good news. That is not good fucking news at all. I'm gonna get my ass kicked. Oh, yeah. Oh, my pants are getting the fuck beaten out of them. This is not good. I'm in a terrible position. I am in a terrible fucking position. And you know what's worse than that? You know what makes this worse? What you're about to see soon. Because if you think this is bad enough, the fucking pedestrians here, this audience that we're growing up here, gets this big. And it keeps growing. And you know what's worse than that? You know what's even worse than that? What's about to happen now? Yeah, Toko's gone. I have no companion, but I have one single thing that can save my ass here. The fucking audience that we're attracting right now. Because they're actually fighting these three dickheads. This is the only thing that's saving me right now. This is the only thing that's actually helping me out. The fact that these people, these random people, are beating the fuck out of these guys in their red jacket bullshit. And by the way, I have the drunken fist on. This is the move for drunken fists. Like, look at this shit. Holy crap. Why can't Nanashi fight as good as he can strip? Like, seriously, look at this shit. Fucking nailed him. And this back flip on the shit, and then the fucking taking the legs. Like, my god. We keep the B in Akiba. Anyway, I'm pretty much going to skip to when I, you know, strip these guys of their fucking clothes, because I do not want to waste your time. But yeah, if it wasn't for the fact these guys that just randomly appeared are stripping the fuck out of these other guys, I would not have done this fucking side mission. I would have just given up. So thank you so much, Ramp Pedestrians, for being the absolute fuck out of those assholes. You have done me some good for once. You've actually become something of usefulness instead of a nuisance. Thank you so fucking much. Oh, and Tucker, you did a good job too. Yeah, you did a good job too. Right, I'm getting the fuck out of these clothes. I do not want to be in these clothes anymore. I don't even want to know these exist. Where's my pants? Is this my pants? No, they're not my pants. There's my pants. That's just washed. And I'm gonna go ahead and wear any shoes. White derbies will do. I'll wear white derbies. Right. Now that I'm out of all the female clothes, because I do not want to fucking wear them, I've just noticed I have a lot of shit. Like, a lot of shit I can use to upgrade my weapons and clothes and shit with. So that'll be good. That'll make me happy. Right now, though, let's get our reward for cross-dressing and being the fuck out of free guys who wanted to bang us. Alright. This was worth it. Well, I now have to fight in the main mission.
Man, sure is quiet here compared to Main Street. So hey, I just want you to know that even if you're not human anymore, you're still the same boy I grew up with. We're still friends. Nothing's changed about that, and nothing ever will. So, you don't have to put up any walls or anything. In the end, you are who you are, and that's what really counts.
Ah!
Holy crap! It's Ren in the flesh! What are you doing in a place like this?
Damn, they caught up!
Over here! Don't let her get away!
What the hell? What's going on? Why are you being chased? I could swear I've seen these guys in black before somewhere, too. Hold up. Aren't these the same Daishihan pharmaceutical goons who attacked you before?
What? She's got backup. Fine, either way. Come on, Ren. Give us back the memory stick and no one gets hurt.
We have you all surrounded. There's nowhere to run.
Wait! How did we get caught up in this?
These people have nothing to do with me.
Maybe they don't, but that's irrelevant. If you cross us, you're not the only one who's gonna pay the price. Take a look around. You want these people to get hurt?
It's hard to believe you'd stoop so low. You ought to be ashamed of yourselves.
What do we do?
We save Friend, of course.
Yeah, yeah. All right, let's put these guys down.
We can handle a few agents, they're nothing. See, we can handle. Okay. So apparently we've just became the Matrix. All of a sudden, we're now finding a shit ton of agents. Apparently I'm near the one. And as you can see, I know Kung Fu. So this is, yeah. I think this was the most appropriate time for me to do this. Now to kick the fuck out of you. Boom, 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 boom. And boom. Now, strike a fucking pose, baby. Boom! That was perfect. That's gonna be the thumbnail. So yeah, I'm firing a shit ton of agents. And they're all part of that pharmaceutical, which is where that chick is working at. So, obviously we can't trust her. Thank fuck I'm not taking her drugs. Right, so this is very interesting, honestly. Like, look at this. Look at how many fucking agents want to beat the shit out of me. And I want you to have a look at how many agents are beating the shit out of Toko. By the way, this is the second fight. The second big fight out of two. Yeah. This one's much bigger. There's a lot more guys. But they're much weaker. The other guys from the first big fight were actually really fucking tough. These guys get the shit taken out of them real quickly, so... It's just by numbers, not by how strong they are. By the way, Toko is pretty much fine at least one or two people. See? Two people. Two fucking agents. I'm fighting a horde. She's fighting two. Good job, Toko. You're doing such a good job for me. You're being such a grand help for me. Where the fuck is... Like, where the fuck's Ren? Where the fuck did Ren go? Wasn't she just here a minute ago? Anyway, things are now going to get much worse than you think. Because while you're thinking, oh hey, I'm going to shoot the fuck out of these guys and get a big combo, I'm going to be really happy about that. The problem isn't in that. The problem is actually in the fact this game cannot handle this fight. No, I'm not kidding. This game actually starts to lag really, really, really badly. And it's gonna be lagging really badly for the next 20 minutes. So, I apologize for all the lag, but this game cannot handle this fight. Like, at all. It will start lagging after this trip time because just watch. It's fucking terrible. But yeah, big combo here. Our biggest combo so far is 16 strip. And we have not gone any better than that. And our gloves have appeared. And they're naked. We just made a whole bunch of agents naked. And now we're over here, and now I'm kicking the fuck out of them where Ren's fighting. So yeah, in case you're wondering how many agents are left, well, Ren's in the way, so I can't really tell, but we've got about 4, 5, 6. We've got a good number of them. One of them's still fine because he has glasses on, apparently. That's a thing. You see, that's a thing with these guys. They fight even when they have nothing but glasses on. It's dumb. It's really dumb. Anyway, this is the point where the game starts to lag horribly. Like, this isn't even a joke. This is where the game actually cannot handle what's going on. There's so much shit in this fucking level right now that it's actually gonna make the game perform really bad. And it's going to affect recording as well. Good news, I leveled up. Bad news, it's lagging now. You might have saw it right there. You might have saw some bit of jittering, some bit of frame rate going down from that punching and shit. Yeah, there we go, now it's starting. Yeah, this is how bad it's gonna get. I keep worrying the game's gonna crash on me because of it. I got lucky though. So yeah, in case you're wondering, the frame rate gets really fucking bad here. This is the game. So, yeah. I apologize for the bad frame rate. I apologize for the lag. But I can't do anything about it. By the way, this guy's frozen. Just letting you know, that guy right there is frozen. I'm pretty sure he's one of the reasons why the game is lagging real badly. And Ren's not fighting. So, yeah, this fight fucked, like, everything up. And it sucks. And I don't like it much. And she took my pants. I wanted those pants. I'll take these pants instead. That's the pants. That's the... Oh, this is good. Look at this fucking move. Like, goddamn. Goddamn. And now I'm done. So, I'm gonna hook some shit, and then we get a very laggy cutscene. Because the rest of this game is gonna lag now.
We got him!
Weren't you the one I saw with Shizuku before?
Are you hurt?
Nobody asked you to come to my rescue, you know.
Wow, what a bitchy thing to say.
Well, you did save me from those guys. I appreciate it. Thanks.
Aw, how cute. She's trying her hardest to be nice now that I called her out.
Oh, shut up. I'm never nice. I mean, yeah, I do appreciate what you just did for me, but I don't want you to ever do it again. Just keep your nose out of this whole Synthester business. And that's not a friendly tip. It's a warning.
Seriously? What's it to you if we are involved? You don't own us. Besides, you're the one who led those guys right into our laps. Why were they chasing you anyway?
Not your business. Though, I do have one more thing to say, and this is a tip. That CEO from Daishihan Pharmaceuticals you've been seeing? I wouldn't turn my back on her if I were you.
Huh? You mean Ms. Kasugai?
There you go. One tip, one warning. Make sure you take it all to heart.
Those were kind of both warnings.
What the hell was that all about, I wonder? I mean, she works for Daishihan, doesn't she? She's like their poster girl. So why would Daishihan thugs be chasing her down?
I don't think this is the last time we'll see her.
Yeah, I think you're right. Anyway, it seems like Rin knows Shizuku too, so... I guess the game's afoot. We've definitely got plenty to report this time around, so we should get back to Mogra on the double.
I was spamming the X button, and it would not continue. So, basically, not only is the game now lagging in its cutscene and even cutting out voice acting, it's also lagging my input. Good. Great. This is a great port. This is honestly a great port. Why was I not expecting this to happen in a fucking port for PC? Like, seriously. And we got some emails. We got the Cosplay Fest email from Akiba's CPS Executive Committee. I keep saying executive. I don't know why. Anyway, it's a special prize, and I don't really care. Let's talk about Mogra. Let's talk about these guys. Let's talk about all the bullshit we know about them right now. Done. And no side missions. But we do have one side mission to do right now, though. But we got a lot of shit. Look at this. We've got a lot of shit. A lot of weapons. A lot of underwear. A lot of pants. And we even got another I can do it. I don't know why we have another I can do it. We just have it. Anyway, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and do the side mission for Spikey now, because the side mission's here, and believe it or not, the guy we're looking for is right here. There's no feeling at all. I mean, if you want to join us. And who's this dickhead? Oh boy. You're pushing him, dude. You can't force the creative spirit. That's wrong. How dare you force the creative spirit, you fucking dick? Oh, I'm taking the... Oh, he's a Sinister! Huh! Well, this is absolutely fine, then. I'm beating the fucking crap out of you, sir. And so is Toko. I mean, I had to fight a fucking horde of agents, sir. You are nothing. I don't know which move I prefer, Shizuku's or Toko's right now. Just look at this. Aw, now I prefer Shizuku. That sucked. That fucking sucked. Yeah, we make a good team. I'm guessing you got rid of the headphones. Now I'm gonna take care of your shirt. Boom, 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 boom. And your pants. I love this fucking moveset. It's awesome. I want to read the last issue! No problem. Are you joining us? I think we already know. Oh, how sad. Used to draw. Yeah, you should go to drawing something that's not fan comics, maybe. Maybe you'll make a lot more out of that. Why's that? Let's not tell him the war sound. Let's not make a joke about this. This is actually kind of serious. Oh. So, a huge fan is giving him shit, and yeah, fan comics is supposed to be a form of respect for the series. It's supposed to be a love for it. Because they're called fan comics for a reason. They're made by a fan. Well, you can't... You're wrong. You're wrong. A fan comic is all about what you want to draw. It's not about what they want, it's about what you want. It's about what you interpret and about what you want to do. Your love for Stripism is the purest form of respect there is. This is actually the best way to say it. See? And I bet you anything, if I fought about any of these, I would fail Spikey's mission. And trust me, like, I don't want to fail any more side missions right now. Thanks. Yep, no problem, dude. And there we go. Joinus is now happy to go back and make more fan comics because he has a love for it. And he wants to. He's not being forced to. He wants to do it. So, Spikey, Enjoy your fucking dojin. The funny thing is, the real Spikestuff would never watch the, read dojin. He would not do that. Unless there are things about Spikestuff that I don't know about. And don't want to know about. So what did you give me? Huh? What did you give me now? 10,000 yen? And what nickname? Fuck you. I'm not. I don't even read dojin. I do not read fucking dojin. Fuck you. I'm the one who brings victory. Not who reads dojin. Fuck you. No, I need you right now. I need you more than ever because I need to upgrade my shit. Alright? I don't want to deal with you, but I need you to upgrade. Because you're the only person who can upgrade my fucking weapons and up my armor. And, well, my clothes. Well, I'm pulling them on anyway. And you're the only person I can do that shit with. So, I need you to synthesize. Weapons first. Combat gloves. Okay, that shit, the acoustic, all this shit. Yeah, just keep upgrading all of these. I need these upgraded. I'm at the 200 part now. I'm in the 200, wait, I didn't explore everything yet. Yeah, I could have missed these. 220 for 15,000. You know what? I'll take it. Freaky, oh great, I upgrade to freaky combat gloves. It's time to get freaky. Okay, I really need to upgrade the hat. Like, it's mandatory. We'll start with this. I'm gonna upgrade these to about... Let's be in the safe side and just go with, 50. 50 will do. Yeah, good. We'll go with that. Done. And I'm gonna need to upgrade the shirt to 50 as well. The pants that are at 40 right now are fine right now, so I don't have to worry about that. Yeah, that'll do. Hold on. Okay. Nice. I am now prepared for the rest of this game, not really. I'll probably be more prepared for about the next 7 main missions. Anyway, I'm gonna sell all the shit I don't need. Including the I can do it, because I already have the I can do it. This is like another I can do it I don't want. And that's about it. Right, let's sell this for that 22,700 yen. That's pretty good. I'm surprised I'm not rich yet. Close to 200,000. That's like 2,000 yen. Okay, now I'm gonna do the main mission. Because now we've actually got some good stats going for us. I could love to have more better stats for the clothes right now, but I think I'll do just fine. And if you have a look at this shit, like, my attack and my defense are doing good, and my ship skill is doing really good too. Like, I got the Dislex normal maxed out. I've got a lot of maxed out. I got a lot of them that are close to maxed out. Like, Dressy is at 85%. And Lolita at 53%. Like, I'm doing good at my ship skills. I didn't have to buy a single fucking book to upgrade this shit. So, you know what? I'm doing perfectly fine. And now it's time to go and do our main mission. But first, I'm going to save just in case the game crashes. Because, as you know at this point, it's lagging really bad. So, I'm not risking it. Let's go and do it now.
You saw Rin being chased by Daishihan flunkies? What the hell's that about?
That's what we'd like to know. I mean, there has to be a damn good story there. Also, it seems like Rin knows Shizuku.
That's...
Yes, yes! Enough mopey! It's time for a big announcement! Here, you take it too, Shizuku! Please look at these pamphlets, everyone!
Akiba Cosplay Fest? I don't understand.
Fest? As in festival? There's a big cosplay contest, and everybody is welcome to enter!
I understand the concept, but what about it?
This year, Akiba Freedom Fighters will transform into Akiba Squad Strip Prism! To put it another way, I signed us up to cosplay SP characters. There are three magical girls in the SP squad, you see? Pink, yellow, and blue. I am dressing as Pink Rism, the pink one. And Toko will be Ambrism, the yellow one.
Wait, Kati, what are you talking about? I never agreed to this.
And I would like for the honor of playing the blue magical girl, Saprism, to fall on you, Shizuku!
That cosplay looks good on you, Shizuku.
What? What? There's no way I can do this. I don't know the first thing about Stripism.
No worries! We can appreciate all 47 episodes of it right now!
Oh, I couldn't help it eavesdrop. We should use this Blu-ray box that I just so happen to have in my hands at this very moment.
Yes! Very nice, little sister! Now we have everything we need!
Do I really need to reiterate that I never agreed to this? Oh, hey, I know! If our resident little sister is so into the show, why doesn't she do it instead?
I can't. It's physically impossible for me to walk around in public shamelessly pretending to be an anime character.
Well, how do you think I feel?
Now, don't be like that. Let's all try our best to win the competition.
Do my objections mean nothing to you?
So, I suppose I'm doing this then.
And so, let the Strip Prism screening begin!
So cool. Even though I've already watched the entire series over 100 times.
How did I let myself get roped into this?
Surely you must know all about SP, right?
I've seen all of it, except for the last episode.
Oh, that's okay. We all pretend the last episode never happened. Now, may I preamble? This is the story of three magical girls who protect the peace of Akiba. Their names are Suzu Toen, Toka Kisumi, and Lily Omi. The show's broadcast stopped 3 years ago, but there are still many fans today.
Please, pay special attention to the outfit changes. Depending on the outfits they're given, each of the girls is able to utilize different powers.
A picture is worth a thousand blurbs. You'll understand when you see it. So let's cut the chatter and enjoy the show!
I have a bad feeling about this.
And that's the end of episode one. So what did you think? Isn't it super duper?
It's not bad. But what the hell is the Akiba Fairy Chiyodon supposed to be?
That's the plushie I always carry around with me. It kind of has the same face as Brontosaurus.
Fairies are a type of earth spirit, I presume?
In this story, Chiyodon is a guardian deity of Akiba. Now settle down. Continue watching!
Wow, can't believe it took 10 episodes before the three of them joined forces. That's a lot slower than I expected.
It's an interesting approach, though.
Huh? Didn't quite catch that.
Never mind, it wasn't important.
Whew, 24 episodes, we've made it to the halfway point. I'd say this calls for a break, wouldn't you?
No! We must keep this tension building all the way to the last episode!
I'm fine to keep watching.
Don't think, just feel.
All right, you win. I'll keep going. Whoa, Shizuku, are you seriously crying?
No matter how many times I watch, SP is still a super great show. Except for the last episode.
The way the SP girls live their lives, it deeply moved me. Except for the last episode.
I can't imagine watching this and not crying.
Except during the last episode.
Kati, do you think I can pull it off? Do you think I can be the cute, precocious, penny-pinching blue defender Lily Omi, aka Saphrism?
I think the role will be in good hands with you, Shizuku.
Then I'll do it. I'll do the Saphrism cosplay.
Shizuku, are you feeling okay? Your whole character seems to have changed.
Fine. I might as well join you guys, too. You need an Ambrism, I'll be your damned Ambrism.
All right, with that settled, let's get your cosplay started. Each of you write down your measurements and discreetly submit them to me.
We're counting on you, little sister. We are the unbreakable wall that keeps Akiba safe from harm. We are Akiba Squad Stripism. Now, we three have come together at last. We shall claim our rightful stardom at the Cosplay Fest.
Hey, sorry to bust in on you when you seem to be having such a ball. But is anybody here free to do me a solid? Got something I want delivered to a friend of mine who runs a shop on Junk Street. It's this here legendary arcade board, Black Panther. It was hell tracking this thing down. But the guy who runs that shop is on the executive committee for the Cosplay Fest, and he's willing to waive the entry fee in exchange for this priceless piece of gaming history he's been searching for his whole life. So yeah, you should get going.
Thank you, Pops. Oh my god, you're a fucking savior. You're the best character so far. You saved my ass. Okay, next on Akiba's trip, we go and deliver a Black Panther arcade board. I mean, fucking board game. We're doing some delivery shit, and we gotta do some fucking cosplay crap, I bet. See you next time!